orders for the execution of 11 civilian prisoners. As for the Marquis, bring him in here. You are the Marquis François Remy, owner of this chateau?
That is correct.
Colonel Schmidt, commandant of the area. You are a collector of rare books, I see. So am I. This first folio of Shakespeare's Hamlet, I would like to buy it from you.
Buy it? Isn't it more usual for a German simply to take what he wants?
I could, of course. But if those pigs in Berlin hear of it, they will confiscate it for one of their museums. I happen to want to keep it for myself. This is a legitimate bill of sale, dated back to 1937 for obvious reasons. I think you will find it in order.
That folio is worth at least $200,000.
Undoubtedly. Possibly a trifle more.
And you are offering me $100.
Plus other valuable considerations, Marquis.
Such as?
Your life, Marquis. You signed a bill of sale, I cancel the order for your execution. Then?
You're sure you want this dated back to 1937?
I said so, did I not? Sign. Very well. Excellent. You may go now. Adjutant, the execution order for the Marquis Remy is now signed.
Can I help you, sir?
Our self and son would like to see Herr Baron Schmidt. Name is Charlie Chan.
The Baron is engaged now, Mr. Chan. You'd care to wait?
Thank you. Not so comfortable.
What a pity, Baron Schmidt, to own such a treasure all these years, and now you must sell it?
I have said that I intend to sell it, Zeigler. Will you act as my agent in the matter?
I shall be honored.
Good. I chose you because your shop has one of the finest reputations in Germany.
Thank you. But I must give credit to Conrad here. Without his rare skill in restoration, I fear my shop might be almost unknown.
You are much too kind, Mr. Zeigler.
Then you will put the Hamlet up for sale to the highest offer over $250,000. You will show it by appointment only, and the terms are cash.
Yes, Baron.
One other thing. You carry complete insurance protection.
A blanket policy. The Hamlet will be covered for its full value.
Good. I imagine you will be bothered by dozens of collectors wishing to see it now that the sale is announced.
Undoubtedly. Several buyers have already arrived in Frankfurt.
Excellent. Well, good day, Zeigler, and good luck. So sorry to keep you waiting, Mr. Chan. That was something I had to attend to myself. Would you care to come in?
Thank you.
And now, why am I favored by a visit from such a famous detective?
I am happy to relate humble detective is also private citizen, with great appreciation for rare books like yourself.
Huh? You are interested in bidding for my Hamlet?
Oh, no. Small pocketbook of a detective could never purchase such expensive and rare treasure. However, we are here because of Sam.
Huh?
You see, my number one son is great camera enthusiast. He would like to beg favor from you.
I figured if you let me take pictures of the Hamlet, you know, page by page, I could present it to my college library. It'd be a feather in my cap.
At his age, feather's most important.
It's a most unusual request.
Oh, I wouldn't hurt it. I would just photograph it.
Well, why not? Meet me tomorrow at Ziegler's bookshop and we will make the arrangements. I'll write the address for you.
No, not necessary. Already known location, but thank you.
I wish I could see it right away. Can't wait to get a look at it, you know, for lights and angles and things like that.
Impatience is a disease of the young. Can only be cured by old age.
I understand this is where Baron Schmidt's first edition of Hamlet is on display.
My name is Lebec, Pierre Lebec.
Sorry, sir. I've no authority to show the Hamlet.
I suggest you see at Ziegler tomorrow for an appointment.
I see. Thank you.
See you again, Charlie.
Thank you.
I'm sorry that you got mixed up in that unfortunate business last night.
Inspector Steiner, I feel that burglar feels more sorry since our timely arrival caused him to leave with empty hands. Great pity. We might even have caught him if number one son had used his head.
He used it for me, the rat. I've been thinking, Inspector. I caught a glimpse of him just before he slugged me, and something about him reminded me of Baron Schmidt.
Would he try and steal his own book?
He might, for the insurance. That way he would have both the Hamlet and the money.
Have you forgotten the Frenchman that Conrad spoke about? The one who held his attention while the other broke in? Pierre Lebec, as he called himself.
Having excellent description of Sam, Inspector, no doubt you have already traced him.
Well, we got as far as the hotel where he registered, but he appears to have left without the formality of checking out.
But if the Baron wasn't in cahoots with him, then who was?
Then you can't arrange for me to see the Hamlet until tomorrow, Herr Baron.
That is the earliest available appointment, I'm afraid.
If I was to tell you I've made a special trip from England.
I'm sorry, Mr...
Arthur Fitzroy. I represent the Shakespeare Historical Society.
Ah, yes. But there are a number of appointments ahead of you, I'm sure you understand.
Yes, of course. I understand it is the folio once owned by the Marquis Remy. Is that so?
It is. I bought it from him in 1937.
1937? Odd.
What is?
Oh, that, he sold it at all. He loved it.
So do I, but there are times when we must all part with what we love.
Forgive me, but as a representative of my society, have you any proof that it was actually the folio owned by Remy?
This bill of sale should be good enough for you.
Quite good enough, Herr Baron.
Here it is, Mr. Chan.
Thank you. Printed in London in 1603. Can you imagine that?
Like the famous jade of the Han period, this is of inestimable value. Also, since there are only two other copies in existence, one at Huntington Library, other at British Museum. Herr Baron, it is a great privilege to be able to look at Sam.
Herr Baron, Mr. Ziegler suggested you might want me to stay tonight while the young man is taking his pictures.
I don't think that is really necessary.
Of course it isn't. If anyone tries another burglary, why, I'll give him a hot reception. Besides, you'll be here, won't you, Pop?
Unfortunately, I have an appointment with Inspector Steiner tonight. like retired fire horse who smells smoke. I cannot resist the lure of police headquarters.
I'm sure young Mr. Chan will see that no harm comes to my hamlet. But if an Englishman called Fitzroy asks to see it tomorrow, have Zeigler keep an eye on him. There's something about him, intuition maybe, but I don't trust him.
He couldn't have bought the book from Remy in 1937. Remy didn't even own it until 1938.
Exactly.
Are you sure the bill of sale was genuine? Maybe Schmidt forged it.
It was Remy's signature. I'd know it anywhere.
There are certain unmistakable markings on Remy's folio. We must check. And if it was Remy's Hamlet, Baron Schmidt won't live to regret the day he got it.
Yes, who's there?
Police headquarters. I'm speaking for Inspector Steiner. Mr. Chen, would you come right over?
Right over? Why?
I'm sorry to tell you, your father has been taken seriously ill.
Yeah, okay, right over.
All tabulated on film.
Most interesting system, Inspector.
Pop, you're okay?
Exceedingly okay. May I ask reason for astonishment?
Yeah, but they sent for me. I got a phone call saying that you were seriously ill. You sent for me.
I did. I certainly did not. Does he often have these hallucinations?
In view of recent burglary, strongly suspect hallucination was induced to lure him from bookstore.
Pop, I left the Hamlet back there on the workbench.
And that is where we are going immediately.
My car's outside. We'll use it.
Can you blame me, Mr. Zeigler? After all, I lost more than $500 worth of equipment in that fire last night.
A trivial matter. Even the damage to my shop is trivial compared to the loss of the Hamlet and the death of Baron Schmidt.
But the fire started after I got that phony call.
There's only your word that there ever was a telephone call.
Why would I lie about it? What reason would I have?
An excuse for your criminal carelessness, perhaps?
My criminal carelessness? What do you mean?
I mean this. Perhaps a flash bulb exploded. Or there was a short circuit in the battery wires. Or perhaps you even left a cigarette burning. Then when you saw the fire starting, you ran away in panic and didn't even try to save the Hamlet.
It's not true.
Excuse me, Mr. Zeigler. Maybe you're a little hard on the young man. We have no proof of these things.
The proof is up to the police. Not that you can be punished for an accident, I suppose.
While you're smoking up your pipe dream, could you tell me how the Baron got killed in the fire last night?
That, too, is a matter for the police.
Pop! This guy's got some crazy ideas that I start...
Later, please. Mr. Zeigler, Inspector Stein and I would like to see you for a moment, please.
Yes, Inspector?
Mr. Chan is kindly assisting me in this case because his son is involved.
In my humble opinion, it is definitely awesome.
I guess you'd like to pin that on me, too.
No, not deliberate arson. But you might be partly responsible, even so.
Please explain.
Well, he might have left in such a hurry, he forgot to lock the door. How else did the arsonist get in?
I swear that door was locked last night.
I sincerely hope same is true. However, must point out, door was found unlocked.
You see?
Now, wait a minute. Night before last, a criminal came in that same door. And if it can happen once, it can happen again. Well, couldn't it?
must concede there is a possibility.
Good. I said all along that Baron Schmidt was the burglar, right? Suppose he came back again last night. Suppose he set fire to the place to cover up his tracks. Suppose it blazed up so fast he couldn't get out.
Nonsense. I refuse to believe that Baron Schmidt had anything to do with it. If there's anything in your theory at all, then you'll find that Frenchman, Lebec, at the bottom of it, if you ever do find him.
We've not given up the search for him yet, I assure you.
Excuse me, Inspector. Headquarters want to speak to you on the telephone.
Thank you. If you will pardon me.
This is where you are using camera, hmm?
Yeah, look at it now. Just a piece of junk.
So your camera is junk. What about the Hamlet? An irreplaceable loss.
Correction, please. At least part of book remains. Inspector, would you kindly have complete analysis made of same?
I'll have it done at once, Charlie. Right now, though, we're faced with another mystery. My office just phoned the autopsy report on the Owen Schmidt. There was no smoke in his lungs, so the fire didn't kill him. He was dead before it started. He'd been shot through the heart.
Thank you.
News, Charlie?
From police friends in Paris, learned that Lebec is well known to authorities there.
A criminal, huh?
Sometimes you amaze me by your genius.
So I'm right.
No, genius for being wrong. Lebec was a war hero.
A hero, huh?
Strangely enough, he was underground expert in arson.
Arson?
Say, that links right up with the bookshop fire.
Could also have connection with Baron Schmidt's service in Nazi SS. Inspector, you think you could get me war record of the late Baron?
I'll see what I can do, Charlie.
I see. Unfortunately, we only learned that late Baron had rank of colonel and commanded small area in occupied Belgium. But what area?
Hey, Pop, I've been watching those boys work on those burnt pages, and you know what?
That examination proved pages were not from genuine first edition of Hamlet.
How'd you know?
In all cases, one must consider even remote possibility.
But what now? If the Hamlet wasn't burnt, then...
Like Lady using makeup. Takes on different face. I'm feeling this new mystery somewhat easier to solve.
Steiner? The Iron Moment, eh? It's for you, Charlie.
Thank you, Inspector. Charlie Chan speaking.
If you want to speak to Pierre Lebec about the bookshop fire, be in a corner booth of the Zwei Kronen taproom at 8 o'clock tonight.
That is Two Crown taproom. Yes, I shall be there. Yes, I shall be alone. Thank you.
Monsieur Charlie Chan.
I have that humble honor. You are Mr. Pierre Lebec? Please sit down. I presume gun is loaded.
I was trained never to bluff with an empty weapon. It's just a precaution. I just want you to listen to my side of the story. That's all.
Would prefer first to hear story of your late friend, Marquis Francois Remy.
How did you know he was my friend?
From information in Paris, I have learned that three very good friends, Marquis Remy, Fitzroy, and Lebec, worked together in underground resistance. But since Marquis's death, now only Fitzroy and Lebec.
His death? His murder? After the war, we learned he had been shot by a Colonel Schmidt, executed without trial. Fitzroy and I spent years hunting the man. But most of the SS files were lost, and there were hundreds of Schmidts.
Then you discovered Baron Kurt Schmidt was putting on sale Folio of Hamlet, book formerly owned by Remy.
It was our first clue, but we never got the chance. Someone killed Schmidt before we got to him.
And you had no connection with Schmidt's death?
Absolutely. Fitzroy and I have mutual alibis. Wait.
Join us now, Fitz, will you?
Tell him where we were last night.
Well, the paper said the police were hunting Lebec. We stayed here together at the inn.
Can you prove that?
Two waiters served our meal. Also, the bartender here will remember us.
Pardon me for busting in, Papa.
So, this is how the famous Charlie Chan keeps his word.
I assure you, I kept promise to come alone. Anxiety of number one son for a parent overrode his discretion. I thought you were in danger, so
No danger. Ex-Chinese policeman not born yesterday. Please take gun.
Attaboy, Pop. Now what?
Telephone Inspector Steiner. Ask him to join me here at once, please.
On the double.
So you're turning us in, even though we are innocent.
If innocent, you have nothing to fear.
We didn't do it. But I'm not sorry he was killed. He deserved to die.
The only pity is, in killing him, someone let the Hamlet be destroyed by fire.
Many rare books were burned in fire, but not Hamlet. Kindly withhold questions until complete answer is found.
I don't want to be rude, Mr. Chen, but can't whatever you want wait till tomorrow? We're taking inventory of the Baron's books for his estate. We'll be probably all night as it is.
I greatly regret interruption, but matter at hand must be taken care of without delay. Inspector.
Search him, Mr. Tiger. Search me back. He held my attention tonight of the first burglary.
Good work, Inspector. And I suppose this is his accomplice.
The word accomplice denotes partnership in crime. No crime committed by these gentlemen.
Then who murdered the Baron?
The solution to mystery is in false telephone call that took my number one son from bookshop. Voice informed you I was gravely ill at Inspector's?
That's right, Pop.
Whoever made call knew I was at headquarters. Neither Fitzroy nor LeBec had this information.
No, I see that. Go on.
Fact was mentioned only before number one son and two others. There was Baron Schmidt. But since he is now dead, there remains only one suspect.
I assure you, I didn't know you were spending the evening with Steiner.
Have not accused you, Mr. Zeigler. There was only one man who knew. Conrad.
No, Mr. Chen. No, Mr. Chen.
In every detective's life, there are moments that are very painful, distasteful. Such a moment is this now for me. It is my unfortunate duty to inform you your guilt is proof. We searched your house, found missing Hamlet. It was you who made phone call. You who stole book and replaced same with cheap edition. You who set shop afire. And you who killed Baron Schmidt.
Yes. It is true, all true. It was the Baron who tried to steal it that first night. I recognized him, but I said nothing. Instead, I planned to take it for myself.
But why, Conrad?
All my life, I worked with rare and beautiful books. They were my life. I loved them. But none of them ever belonged to me.
But to kill a man for that?
The Baron caught me setting the fire. He was after the Hamlet again, you see. I drew a gun. It went off. And I saw he was dead. I left him there.
Yeah. Ich verstehe, danke. So, it seems Conrad won't stand trial after all. He's had a heart attack and he's not expected to live.
Very great pity. One can only regret sad ending to life dedicated to rare books.
Monsieur Lebec, we have received permission for the folio of Hamlet to go back to France. It never legally belonged to Schmidt.
Thank you very much, Inspector. And thanks for letting me photograph it. It's all in here, every page of it.
A great pleasure.
One more item remains. Kindly return to Mr. Lebec gun you took last night.
I forgot.
Keep it, a souvenir. Very grateful for generosity, but must refuse. Pistol in hands of number one son is like giving child stick of dynamite. Too dangerous.
Pop, it's absolutely safe. I can handle this any.
You see what I mean?
Holy mackerels, it's got holes in it.
So has head.